If your LED bulb suddenly stops working, don't be too quick to throw it away. In this DIY project, I'll show you how to open up a broken LED bulb and check which part has failed. Sometimes it's just a loose wire, a burnout diode, or a faulty resistor. With a few simple tools and a bit of patience, you can bring your old bulb back to life and save it from going to waste. Let's roll up our sleeves and see how to fix it right at home. I have two LED bulbs in my hands. I tested the first bulb. It still lights up and works normally, which means there's no issue with the power source or the socket. It's always a great feeling when a quick check like this confirms everything is in good condition. This helps narrow down the problem to the second bulb, the one that doesn't light up. When I plugged in the second bulb, it didn't light up. That means there's likely an issue inside, maybe with the LED chips, the driver circuit, or a loose connection. So now, I'll take it apart to find out exactly what's wrong and see if we can bring it back to life. I carefully open the outer shell of the bulb using a utility knife, slowly work it around the edge where the plastic cover meets the aluminum base. Be gentle at this step, because the plastic cover can crack easily if too much force is applied. Once the cover came off, I could clearly see the LED board and the driver circuit inside. Now, I'll take a closer look to check for any burnt marks, loose wires, or damaged components. There were no burn marks anywhere, so it's probably not a power issue. That means some of these LED chips might be damaged. When even one chip burns out, it can break the entire circuit and cause the whole bulb to stop working. So now, I'll test each chip one by one to find out which one is faulty. I'm going to use these three Samsung phone batteries to make a small tool for testing each LED chip. By connecting them in series, I can create a simple power source strong enough to light up individual LEDs. Before connecting the batteries, I check their voltage one by one using a multimeter. Each Samsung phone battery should ideally read around 3.7 to 4.2 volts if it's still in good condition. That means these batteries are still usable and can be combined to create a stable power source for testing the LED chips. Next, I fix the three batteries together using hot glue. I align them side by side, making sure the terminals are all facing the same direction, then apply a thin layer of hot glue between each one to hold them firmly in place. Once the glue cools and hardens, the battery pack becomes solid and easy to handle, perfect for our DIY LED tester setup. After the glue is cooled, I wrap an extra layer of electrical tape around the batteries to make the pack even more secure. Now the battery pack feels firm and safe to use, ready for the next step of wiring it up for the LED test. Next, I pay close attention to the battery terminals. The positive and negative ends must be connected correctly. I arrange them so that the positive terminal of one battery connects to the negative terminal of the next, creating a series connection. Then, using a soldering iron and a bit of solder, I carefully join the terminals together. It's important to work quickly and gently to avoid overheating the batteries. By connecting the three batteries in series, the total voltage increases enough to power the LED chip. A single phone battery isn't strong enough to light it up. Once all the joints are done, I let them cool for a few seconds. Now the battery pack is neatly soldered, strong, and ready to deliver stable power for testing the LED chips. Before testing the LED chips, I measure the total voltage of the three connected batteries. Since these batteries are quite old, the reading shows only about 8 volts instead of the usual 11 to 12 volts. Even though the voltage is a bit low, it's still enough to light up individual LED chips for testing. This step helps me know exactly how much power I have before using the pack, avoiding any risk of underpowering or overloading the LEDs. To take the measurement properly, I first need to finish assembling the testing tool. For this, I'll use a paper clip. It's simple but really handy. I straighten the clip, then bend in slightly to create two small probes. These will act as contact points that I can easily touch to each LED chip. Once attached to the wires from the battery pack, the paper clip becomes a lightweight and practical tester tip, perfect for checking each LED one by one. Next, I connect the paper clip probes to the wires from the battery pack. I strip a bit of insulation off the wire ends, then wrap them tightly around the paper clips to ensure good contact. To make the connection stronger and more stable, I add a small amount of solder on each joint. Now, the tester is fully assembled, with the wires delivering power from the battery straight to the paper clip probes, ready to check each LED chip. Now, let's start checking the LED chips to find the faulty one. When testing, pay attention to the LED chip's polarity. It has two terminals. The red wire is a positive side, and the black wire should touch the negative side. If the chip lights up, it's still good. If it doesn't, that's the one that's burned out. Let's see which one is causing the problem. after finding the faulty LED chip. I'll mark it with a small dot using a marker so I don't lose track of it later. As I tested each chip one by one, most of them lit up normally, until I found one that didn't light at all. No matter how many times I checked, it stayed completely off. That means this is a faulty chip, causing the whole bulb to stop working. Now that I've found the problem, it's time to replace or bypass this damaged LED chip so the bulb can shine again. Now it's time to remove the faulty LED chip. I'll use a small knife to remove the faulty LED chip. I have another burnout bulb, and I'm going to reuse the LED chips from it for replacement. Even though that bulb no longer works, some of its LED chips are still in good condition, perfect for spare parts. I heated the solder with a lighter until it softened and began to melt. I moved the flame gently and quickly, just enough to warm the solder pad, so I could lift the LED chip away with tweezers. Pay attention to the solder on each side of the LED chip. One side usually has a little more solder than the other. The side with less solder is the positive terminal. That's a useful detail to remember when installing the new chip, since most LED boards don't have clear polarity markings. So when placing the replacement LED, I'll align the side with less solder to the positive pad and the side with more solder to the negative pad. Getting the polarity right is important. If it's reversed, the LED won't light up. Now I'll replace the LED chip using a lighter to heat the solder. I'll position the new chip in place, making sure the side with less solder is on the positive terminal. Then, I'll gently heat the pad from underneath until the solder melts and the chip settles flat onto the board. Once it cools down, the solder will harden again, securing the LED firmly in place. It's a simple but effective way to attach the chip when you don't have a soldering iron. Just remember to be careful with the heat and keep the flame at a safe distance. After replacing the LED chip, I'll reattach the bulb to its base to test it. I carefully screw it back in and make sure the connections are secure. Then I plug it in and it lights up perfectly. The light is now shining very evenly across all the LED chips. There are no dim spots, flickers, or uneven brightness. It looks just like a new bulb. This shows that the replacement chip is properly installed and the connections are solid. It's really satisfying to see such a consistent, bright glow after a successful repair. There's no sign of flickering or intermittent connection at all. The bulb stays steady and bright, which means the circuit is stable and the new LED chip is making perfect contact. It's reassuring to see that the repair is reliable and the bulb can now be used safely without any issues. It's amazing how such a simple setup, just a paper clip and a Samsung battery, can become a powerful little testing tool. With this DIY tester, I can quickly check each LED chip without needing any expensive equipment. It's a perfect example of clever simplicity, a tiny, low-cost solution that makes troubleshooting fast, effective, and surprisingly satisfying. And that's it. With just a few simple tools, some careful soldering, and a little DIY creativity, we brought a dead LED bulb back to life. Not only does this save money, but it also helps reduce electronic waste. It's amazing how a small repair can make a big difference. Now, the bulb is fully functional and ready to shine again, proving that with patience and the right approach, almost any broken LED can be fixed at home